Good morning, guys. It's your boy Cam, the Chevy man. I just done the driveway. Looks pretty good. Went to the river and picked up some rocks. And done that half of my driveway in rocks because there was a big old drop off right here and I figured I'd fix that. But that's not what the video is about today. What I did today to my magnaflow muffler was got all the fiberglass out of it. Find out which trash bag I put it in. Right here, as you can see all that fiberglass in there. Yes, the magnaflow mufflers, they do have fiberglass in them. So what I did was I took a screwdriver and dug a little hole in it. As you can see where it welded it up, right there. Can't really zoom in on it. That little hole welded up right there. Right there, yep. I took a screwdriver and hammered it. And then I took one of those, I forgot what them things are called. Things you put the sockets on and twist. I got the back of that and made the hole wider with the hammer. I hammered that too. And it made it about almost an inch thick hole. No, not quite an inch, but close. But yeah, I got all of that fiberglass out. And there was also some steel mesh in there. I couldn't get that out. It was stuck. And I got a clothes hanger and just dug all that fiberglass out. And then I got to the steel mesh and my freaking clothes hanger got hung up in the muffler. So I had to snip it off and just push the rest of it off in there that was left in there. But the truck didn't really sound much louder. I tried to put some water down in that pipe and flush the rest of it out, that fiberglass out, but I don't know if it worked or not. Let's see if I can find my keys and start it up. I still have water in my mufflers, but that'll be fine. See if I can find the key. There she is. Always find something to do during the day to keep me productive. Always, there's some fiberglass right here. I didn't sweep up, I guess. It looks like blonde hair is what it looks like. I tell you, that stuff ain't fun to get on you. I had to take a shower and wash all my dang clothes, and I'm still itching a little bit. But it happens. Yeah, it's not that loud right now because I still have water inside of it. See how much I can spray out. I'm not gonna get it out that way. I'm gonna have to drive it around for a little bit. I can tell it's still in there. I'm gonna have to get the muff muffler hot so it'll boil that water and just vaporize it all out. The reason I put water in there is just to clean out all the rest of the extra stuff that was left in there. I've had this truck for like 3 years now, or maybe more. The only major problem I had was the transmission going out. I've never had any problems with the engine. The engine's really good. I do have some knock sensors out because I sprayed it with a car wash deal at the car wash. And I'll replace those sooner or later. I think when I get back, I'm gonna go and take all my tires and stuff off my truck and freaking grease the brake systems and stuff down, just because I need to do the front so these ABS lights will go off. I think that's what it is, like the sensors and stuff down there are dirty. So I'm gonna try and clean that off, because I'm tired of seeing them. Y'all, that water's starting to come out now. I can hear my truck getting louder. Had to negotiate with whoever this is in the road with this big tractor. And they didn't wave back. Buttholes. Turn this radio up. I didn't even know 104.5 worked on mine. I guess it does. Oh, Ike. CJ somewhere in the avalanche. He waved back. My nigga. I can't stand when people don't wave back. The next time I wave at somebody they don't wave back, I'm gonna flip them off. I'm flipping the bird. They deserve it. That's a butthole move not to wave back at somebody when they wave at you. That's just rude. Go drive to the warehouse you're signing back. They can wait. Starting to get louder now. All that water is coming out. That harness I made, it still hasn't gave up on me yet. I need to go ahead and get one that came with it though, instead of the one I made, because just to be on the safe side. I mean, this one hasn't gave up on me yet. So until then, I guess I'll just use it. But I had to get me the harness that actually is made for the stereo pretty soon. Yeah, so guys, if you ever want to hollow out your Magnaflow muffler, get a screwdriver, clothes hanger. I still forgot what that tool is called. It's a tool that you put a socket on and you like twist to loosen a bolt. I'm pretty sure some of y'all know what that is. It's not a ratchet, but I don't know what you call it. I done forgot completely. This muffler sounds a little bit beefier than I took the fiberglass out, but you can't really tell a whole lot. I mean, it's still got steel mesh inside of it, so that's keeping some of the sound in. But it definitely sounds now. Here at Herndon. All right, guys, I'm in this video for you. Subscribe for content. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Keep it real. And remember, guys, Jesus loves you. Have a good day.